Advertising is often slammed as the evil henchman of rampant consumerism. But can its awesome power also be used for good? Simon Pound checks out a social marketing campaign that's changed how we view depression.
The advertising around mental health and depression has been both effective and measurable. The Like Minds, Like Mine campaign helped to move mental health from being a taboo topic to mainstream acceptance. A lot of this had to do with the pioneering use of well-known personalities sharing their experiences, like ex-All Black John Kerwin.
If you're in there freaking out, hang on to hope. Grab hold of it.
That campaign's been extremely successful. We've had over 90% recall of those television ads. People love John Kerwin, of course.
Just reach out, and if you tell someone and they don't get it, go and tell someone else until you get someone who gets it.
We know there's been a significant change in terms of attitudes and behaviours towards people with mental illness over the last 10 years.
The advertising campaign that suggested people call for help was so successful it caught Candice's team out.
When the campaign started, we had expected maybe, you know, 20 or 30 calls a day based on previous campaigns. We were getting 200-300 calls a day.
And now the Ministry of Health, working with their long-time communication agency Draft FCB, are building on this success with an e-therapy program called The Journal. And John Kerwin is back fronting the ads.
Looking back when I first experienced depression, staying active was probably one of the best things I could have done.
And he's also the online coach for The Journal.
Welcome to the program. This is your journal where you'll have lessons and record your progress. Now, I'll be coaching you, and like all coaches, I'll be bringing in experts to help me out and giving you tasks to practice along the way.
What's innovative about The Journal, actually, just not from just New Zealand, but worldwide, is that it's an online self-help program. It's been developed with medical professionals, and we've taken a lot of the, approved and medically approved theories and taken those through to an online application that people can go through in their own time, in their own place.
So it's an online therapy aid that helps people learn techniques to help themselves. And it's presented and designed in such a way so as to encourage people to keep getting the benefits.
It's very different from other programs internationally because we have used advertising. We know that one of the main problems with these programs is that people tend not to finish them. With using advertising, we maintain the interest in the program and we encourage them in many different ways, using internet technology and texting and so on, to keep doing the program, to stick with it.
This is great. Looks like all your hard work has paid off.
This program was 2 years in the making. Unlike most communication campaigns, it's been tested with medical supervision for 3 months.
There's a much higher risk when we're dealing with people's lives and you know, their experiences. So we need to really prove that what we're doing, we've looked into all the risks.
So far, the response has been staggering.
The journal's only been up and running for a week. On the website, we've had in excess of 35,000 hits, and then 1,300 people have signed up for the journal, which was a great start.
It's just been phenomenal. In 1 week, we had over 1,000 people registering for the program. That's unprecedented.
And it's also cost-effective. The project was $900,000 to set up, but once it's there, it can keep helping people again and again. And for Brian and Candice, working in advertising that helps people is rewarding both professionally and personally.
I find it very rewarding working on social change, particularly when we see the numbers come back and see the positive benefits that we're delivering into New Zealand communities.
Oh, it's fantastic. I love it.
Depression.org.nz. I'll see you there.
OK, Simon, what's the secret to this campaign's success?
Well, it appears to be John Kerwin. Health departments all around the world and governments have wanted to do similar initiatives in their countries, but they haven't been able to find a central figure to share experiences that so many people relate to. He is just popular with men, women, sports fanatics, and he's really respected. And probably the most interesting thing about it for him is that he doesn't ask for any fee for all the work he does as well.
Brilliant. Fantastic campaign from Draft FCB. And that isn't all the public good advertising that you've been digging into this week, is it?
Yeah, I've found a bit of a selection of work from all around the world for this week.
In Brazil, they recently went to zero tolerance for drunk driving. They drove the message home with this trick. Punters paying their bar tab had the potential costs of a drink drive accident added to the bill. Check out the shock and surprise. While over in Sweden, they have a problem with young women smoking, so they got inventive.
Young women were invited to participate in an online casting at umodels.se.
Wannabe models submitted a photo and answered questions about looks and smoking habits. In return, they got emailed back.
U stands for ugly, you know? We are the model agency for smokers.
Hit them where it hurts, their looks. This print ad from India is direct. And finally, here is some lovely work for Amnesty International, using the Amnesty candle to put the heat on countries still enacting the death penalty.
And if you'd like to see more of those ads, visit us at tvnz.co.nz/theadshow. After the break, we talk search.